Thank you for watching this video. Today we will be doing technical analysis on the S&P 500 for Tuesday, September 28th, 2021. And for this analysis, we will be using stockcharts.com. That is the charting service that I use and pay for. And I will leave a link to their site in the description box below this video. My name is Rodney Constable. I have over 30 years of investing experience, including over 25 years of experience trading stocks and options. I am a former financial advisor, a former vice president of a major mutual fund company, and I am the developer and president of Simple Market Signals at simplemarketsignals.com. Simple Market Signals is a proprietary trend direction and risk management model. The first chart that we're going to look at here is a 5-day, 5-minute chart of the S&P 500. We're going to start here just real quickly so we can kind of see the volatility that we've had over the last 5 trading sessions. Of course, right here on the right-hand side, that is today's trading for Tuesday, September 28th. And you can see we gapped down at the open and continued to sell off pretty much all day and then finished really close to the lows of the session. We were down 2.04% today on the S&P 500, and the S&P 500 closed at 43.52.63. The next chart that we're going to look at is an hourly candlestick chart of the S&P 500 that starts on the first trading session of July. The horizontal blue lines, the top one here is 44.40, the next one down is 44.30, and then the bottom one here is 43.05. Now, we know that this 44.30 to 44.40 trading range, this has been a super important trading range on the S&P 500 really since the end, you know, towards the latter part of July, where the S&P 500 got right up to this 44.30 level, couldn't get through it, got rejected, and then finally penetrated that on August 6th, then it went sideways, kind of sandwiched between 44.30 and 44.40 for a few sessions, and then broke above it, got rejected, broke below it, and then finally got above it. The reason this is so important is last week, of course, when we fell off and sold down to this 43.05 level last Monday, so a week ago, about 6 trading sessions, we only stayed there for a brief period and then ricocheted right back up, and then by the end of the week, we had closed above this 44.40 level. Now, if you haven't seen my video from last Friday, the 24th, please go back and look at that for some more perspective. Yesterday on Monday, we were able to stay above this 44.40 level, but again, you can see today we gapped down and then went down to this 43.50 level. So the good news so far is we haven't went back to where we were a week ago on Monday, but we're once again underneath this really critical 44.30 to 44.40 trading range. So this area now is going to act as overhead resistance. You know, and the fact that we rolled back over here, not good news, but we have quite a few charts to look at today, so please stay with me. One more thing on this chart before we move forward, because it'll give us some perspective. The all-time intraday high, I just abbreviated this ATIDH, was back on 9-2, September 2nd, and that was at 45.85. So 45.85 right now, that is the all-time intraday high on the S&P 500, and that will come into play here, not only today, but going forward. So just kind of memorize that, and that'll help give us some perspective. The next chart that we're going to look at is also an hourly candlestick chart of the S&P 500. However, we just kind of shrunk up the time on this, and we're going to start on August 27th. And the reason we did is I wanted, again, you know, be able to put this all-time intraday high right here into perspective. Now, the black overlaid line on top of the S&P 500, which are the candles, but the solid black line is the IEF. Okay, if you're not familiar, that is the price of the 10-year Treasury ETF. So it's a 7 to 10-year Treasury ETF. And the point here, guys, and whether you're just a pure equity person or if you're an asset allocator, please, you know, just stay with me and pay attention, because this is super educational and very important. But what you see here is that this black line has been going down along with the S&P 500. What this means is that high quality bonds folks are selling off with equities, okay? And that has, and please stay with me, this is going to be a super educational video today, as I hope they always are for you, but I have a lot of real key points to make here. And one of them, and this is something I've been warning my subscribers about for quite a while, is the potential for high quality bonds to be going down with equities, okay? And that is exactly what we're seeing here as of late. As a matter of fact, and this is just the performance of three different ETFs. We have the 3 to 7 year, the 7 to 10 year, and the 20 year plus ETF. Here's the tickers over here. And guys, this is just the last week, okay? This is a rolling 1 week return. But look at this. The IEF, which is the 7 to 10 year, now that's where most people would probably be, you know, 10 year treasuries offsetting equity risk. You know, it's always been that way, right? Where, you know, people use about the 10 year or longer to offset equity risk. And hey, you got a 60, 40, 70, 30 portfolio. And guess what? The bonds themselves, so let's say you're in a 60, 40 with 40% of your holdings in the bonds themselves are down 1.74% this week. So my point in talking about the yield being roughly 1.5 somewhere in that window, it's been going up actually, but let's call it 1.5% on the 10-year treasury, is that if you really understand how bonds work, your yield, right, in this case the 1.5%, over time becomes your total return. That's kind of the, you know, the way bonds are should be thought about. So the point is, if the yield is only 1.5% and you already lost 1.74% this week, right? You know, I mean, you've lost your entire annual return in 1 week on this 7 to 10 year ETF. Okay. So anyway, just moving on here, you can see the 3 to 7 down 82 basis points. Look at this, the TLT, the 20 plus year, the long duration down 4.51% this week, guys, this week. All right. So this really points to some fundamental problems in the bond market, and this is why I believe, and stay with me here, super important stuff, that it's going to be really hard going forward for traditional asset allocation. We'll talk a little bit more about that here, but you know, just understand that, you know, bonds, and think about what I'm about to say here, guys. Bonds represent a return-free risk. Let me repeat that. Bonds at these yields and with what we're seeing, and then there's potential for more damage going forward, guys. Don't make any mistake about it. Bonds represent a return-free risk, okay? So think about what I just said. Let's move on. Let's move on to a daily candlestick chart of the S&P 500 that starts back at the first of 2021. The three moving averages, we have the green one, which is the 50-day, the orange one, which is the 100, the blue one, which is the 200-day, and you can see we're still quite a ways above that right now. So far, and by the way, the blue line here, this horizontal blue line is set at 43.50, which is pretty much where we pulled back to, okay? And we'll zero in and we'll zoom in on this little area here in just a minute. But all we've really done so far, and we haven't even quite gotten down there, is from that all-time intraday high right here. So far, all we've done is pulled back to just above the 100-day moving average. Again, we stopped at 43.5263 today, right? And this is that 43.50 line. Now, when we zoom in, so to speak, on this chart, and I'm going to bring it forward to where the starting point is July, right? So we can zoom in. You can see that the last 3 days, again, each one of these candles represents one day of trading. You can see that these candles right here all stopped short of, right on the bodies. Now the wicks, you know, went down below there, but none of these daily candles closed below this 43.50 line. So it's possible that this, you know, 43.50 level is going to act as support, and maybe that's all we're doing is going down to this, stopping and stopping just short of the 100-day moving average on the daily closes. However, I think that's, you know, possibly a little optimistic, right? You know, it's been a long time since we pulled back to the 200-day moving average. You know, the market is getting a little heavy here, so I think the statistical probabilities have at least increased, right, over the last few weeks that, you know, we may be pulling back towards that 200-day moving average. There's no guarantee, of course, it'll stop, you know, even if we get down there, right? It could go lower. But also let's do a little bit more annotation on this chart, and because you can see here this 4350 level, there's some trading here, but really the thick area of trading is, you know, to get a little thicker, we've got to get down to this 4200 level, as you see there, right? A lot more trading, maybe, you know, 4175, 4150. So I, you know, let's just put this line around 4175, about right in there. Okay, that should, let me just stop that. Yeah, okay, pretty close. All right, so since we're doing this on the fly. All right, so we have a rising 200-day moving average. You know, by the time the market rolls over, if it takes a few more sessions, we could have this 40-day a little closer to this line here, but it's probably somewhere in this. I'm just going to go ahead and drop in another horizontal line here, guys, and hopefully you like the fact that I'm doing this live. But I'm going to put this other one here around 4125, just kind of connect it right here with the where the 200-day moving average is setting right now, as you can see, about 4125. So somewhere between 4125 and 4175, you know, 4150 plus or minus, that area represents a whole lot more trading, right? There's a thick area right there where we traded for well over a month between middle of April and the middle of May. So if the market is rolling down towards, right, if this 100-day moving average doesn't hold over the next week or two, then I think it's very likely that we'll find ourselves somewhere down here in this 4125 to 4175 level, and that would get us down, you know, right around that 200-day moving average. So it may not happen, but we need to prepare ourselves for that possibility. Now, there's no guarantee, of course, that the 200-day moving average would be as low as the market goes. But we'll address that if we drop below the 200. We'll address it when it happens. But for right now, I think it might be a little optimistic that we're going to stay above that 100-day moving average based on, you know, what we're seeing in the charts here. Okay, so it could happen, but at least be prepared. Right, hope for the best, prepare for the worst. And right now, it looks like, you know, there's a high probability of us dropping further and perhaps going down towards that 200-day moving average at this time. Now I want to give you a few things to think about. Now, first off, the stock market and the economy are not the same thing, okay? So just think about that. If you love studying the economy, that's great. You know, that's fantastic, but it's extremely difficult to study economic information and try to figure out how that might affect the stock market. The other thing to think about, guys, is that economic data is lagging information. In other words, by the time you get the information, whatever you're studying has already happened. It's all past tense. All right. So this is why I do all of my work on the stock market itself. It took me a lot of years to realize that. But, you know, studying the economy and trying to figure out the stock market because of the economic information, I have found it virtually impossible. The stock market is where we need to spend our time, okay? Now, the other thing, I already showed you in the charts, but high-quality bonds are selling off with equities. That is not good. What this means is that asset allocation won't work like it used to, okay? And take it for what it's worth, guys, but having a diverse portfolio and, oh, I'm conservative, or I've got bonds, or, you know, I've got a bunch of different holdings, guys, it's probably not going to protect you like it used to, and it's definitely not going to work like, you know, when the 10-year treasury was yielding 5%, you know, a dozen years ago, okay? So what this means, of course, is that a 60-40 or 70-30 portfolio, it's going to underperform going forward, all right? Think about, you know, a few minutes ago I showed you that bonds are down, you know, in some cases, you know, 4-5% this week, right, on the 20-plus year, the longer duration stuff. So as yields rise, bond prices fall, that's exactly what we're seeing. And remember, you know, bonds represent a return-free risk, all right? So going forward, based on my decades of experience, right, my financial services background, if you don't know that, check out the video that will be in the that will be linked in the description box below this video if you want to learn more about my background. But based on my decades and decades of service in financial services, my trading and investing experience, guys, it's, you know, it's cash and equities, right? You know, going forward, you're going to have to be invested in equities when the time is right. And then, you know, probably cash. Now, this is not advice. This is my opinion, right? I can't give you advice because I don't know your individual circumstances. But at least consider the fact that I might be right about this, that equities and cash may be the better option. However, you will need a market-based system to help you toggle back and forth between equities and cash, okay? So that, I think, is going to be, for a lot of people, could be a superior strategy to where you could pick up more upside when the equities are running, right? And when things are acting right in the equities market. However, when this market-based system, gives you a heads up that the odds of making money in equities are going to start to go against you, you might want to pull back on the equities and increase your cash position, okay? Now, if this makes sense to you, stay with me for another few minutes here because I have something to share with you that could literally change your life, okay? No joke. So invest the next 15 minutes watching the balance of this video because what I have to share with you literally could change your life if it's right for you. Let me ask you a question. Do you have a stock market risk management and trend direction system in place? Do you know the various risk levels in the stock market on an ongoing basis? Do you know when it's safest to be in equities? Do you know when it's most dangerous to be in equities? Do you know the direction of the trend of the stock market? My system is Simple Market Signals. Simple Market Signals is market-based. There's no opinions, forecast, or guesswork in Simple Market Signals. It took me over 20 years to develop Simple Market Signals. I developed Simple Market Signals by reverse engineering the stock market, and I studied the stock market over numerous time frames, including numerous bull and bear markets. And what I found is that certain conditions exist during various market phases, and then I created simple, easy-to-understand signals around these different phases of the markets. And the thing is, guys, that most people don't know about or have access to the data necessary to do the research that I had to do to create this model. Simple Market Signals is a proprietary stock market risk management and trend direction model. And Simple Market Signals is perfect for financial professionals and individual investors. There's two major components to the proprietary model. There's a risk level signal and there's the general trend indicator. Let's start off with the risk signals. The risk signals are simply green, yellow, and red. The green signal has the lowest equity risk associated with it. And what you're going to find is that most all upward progress in the stock market will be made in a green signal environment. Said another way, it is hard to make money in equities unless the signal is green. The yellow signal means there's moderate equity risk, and sideways to slightly up or down price action is very common during a yellow signal environment. The red signal has the highest equity risk, and the worst sell-offs, including bear markets, will happen when the signal is red. A quick review of the risk signals. The green signal is the best risk-reward ratio signal for equity investors. And what you're going to find is that most upward progress in the stock market will happen in a green signal environment, as we see here. The red signal is the worst risk-reward ratio signal for equity investors. And what you're going to find is that the worst downturns, including the downturn in Q4 of 18 and the bear market in Q1 of 2020, plus the bear market from 2000 through 03 and the bear market of 07 through 09, all of those are going to take place in a red signal environment. Now let's put it all together and see how Simple Market Signals could have helped you during the fastest bear market in history, which of course happened during Q1 of 2020. We had a strong stock market coming into 2020, so the risk signal was green coming into 2020 and remained green for the majority of January. We did have a yellow signal for about 2 weeks towards the latter part of January, first part of February, and then, of course, the risk signal went back to green. And then on February 19th, we hit what was at that time the all-time high on the S&P 500. Again, that's February 19th. And then things started to unravel from there. But think about this. Just a few days after the all-time high at that time in the S&P 500, on Monday, February 24th, the risk signal went yellow. And then on Tuesday, the 25th of February, the general trend indicator went negative. And that general trend indicator had been positive since October of 19, okay? So right there, just a few days after the all-time high in the S&P 500, the risk signals started to tell you that something was changing, that there was increasing risk in the stock market. And by Thursday, February 27th, the risk signal was red. And then, of course, the market sold off hard from there. So think about this, guys. I mean, you talk about stress testing my model. During the fastest bear market in history, just you know, that started just a few days after the all-time high at that time, the all-time high in the S&P 500, in 1 week, the risk signal went yellow, the trend indicator went negative, and then the risk signal went red, all in the same calendar week, actually within 4 days, right? Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday. So you talk about stress testing my model. Guys, I mean, this is the fastest bear market in history, and look at how simple market signals could have helped you during that time. With simple market signals, you will know what the risk level is and what the trend direction is in the overall U.S. stock market. And the proprietary model is based on S&P 500 data. The S&P 500 index really is the best proxy for the overall U.S. stock market. And it's the only index that has all of the data available that I need to run the model. And guys, it's not about beating the S&P 500. However, that is a possible outcome over time if the tools within the model are employed properly. It's about risk management and risk control. It's about controlling your risk exposure rather than letting the whims of the market dictate your future. The best fit for simple market signals is an investor or a financial professional with at least a 6 to 8 week plus time frame that they're focusing on. If you're a shorter term trader or a day trader, simple market signals may help you a little bit, but the reality is that the best fit between simple market signals and a subscriber is somebody that has at least a 6 to 8 week time frame or more that they're focusing on. The signals are delivered to subscribers, our members, in our weekly video. A Simple Market Signal subscription, a membership, is now available to the entire YouTube global viewing audience via a paid membership to this YouTube channel. Let's talk about the membership details. So the video or YouTube membership to Simple Market Signals is $19.99 per month. And that's a recurring billing, right? So every month you're going to be billed $19.99 per month. Guys, that's less than 67 cents a day. And this will be billed monthly on your credit card through YouTube, which of course is owned by Google. A video membership to Simple Market Signals via a membership to this channel will give you access to all the information necessary to be successful with Simple Market Signals. With your membership, you will get weekly updates on our proprietary risk level signal on the overall U.S. stock market. You will also receive the proprietary risk level signals on all 11 major sectors of the S&P 500, and you will receive the proprietary general trend indicator signal for the overall U.S. stock market, and you will get all of these each and every week. So just to confirm the signal update frequency, we will upload a new video each week updating all signals within our model, regardless of whether there's been any signal changes or not. And that video will be uploaded each weekend, generally on Saturdays before 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. But depending on our production schedule, that video could be uploaded anytime over the weekend. We will also add a new video to the member area if there is any signal changes in the middle of the week. So if there's a signal change on either the overall risk signal or the general trend indicator, we will also give you midweek updates when necessary. But generally, each week there will be one video updating everything and confirming what the signals are for that time period. And again, those videos are generally uploaded on Saturday, and our goal is to get it out before 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. However, again, the video could go out anytime over the weekend. So again, just to confirm, all signals are updated every weekend. Major signals will be updated midweek if there is a signal change. As a member, you will also have access to best practice videos for successful implementation of the risk signals and the general trend indicator. And you will also have access to best practice educational videos for tips on successful investing. And this video library will continue to expand over time. So as part of your membership benefits, you will have 24/7, 365 access to all signals and, of course, the charts from the past all the way to the current. And you will have access to all of those charts up to the present and, of course, any future charts, right? We update those every week. You will also have 24/7, 365 access to all related educational videos. And, of course, the membership is available globally wherever YouTube is available. And any of you that have looked at this in the past, you know that that's new. In the past, I could only offer this to U.S. citizens. But anybody that now has access to YouTube on a global basis can have access to Simple Market Signals, can have a subscription, a membership to Simple Market Signals with this new business model running everything through the YouTube membership area. And of course, all of the information is disseminated via video. There's no print or email with this particular membership. Now let's talk about some additional membership details. Guys, you can cancel your membership anytime, okay? And if you do cancel, you won't be billed for the next billing cycle, the next month, if you do cancel. However, your membership will remain active for the balance of the prepaid period, the current month that you're in. If you do cancel, there won't be any refunds for the balance of the prepaid month remaining after cancellation, and there's no free trial period. And of course, this is controlled by YouTube. This has nothing to do with me. These are the parameters that YouTube sets for any membership that you have that's connected to the membership area of YouTube. A few important details. There won't be any changes to current subscribers of the emailed version. For those of you that are domiciled in the U.S., you're a current subscriber to Simple Market Signals, nothing is going to change for you. And there's no change to the free weekly market videos that I'm putting up on YouTube. So if you've been watching my videos, I don't know, 250, 260, whatever are out there now over the last few years, I've uploaded these. I'm still going to be doing that every week. So I'm still going to be putting out that free weekly video, giving you a brief update on the markets. And again, if you are a current subscriber to Simple Market Signals and you receive your information via email, nothing is going to change. So let's review the membership details. The video membership to Simple Market Signals through this YouTube channel is $19.99 per month. That's a recurring billing, right? So YouTube is going to bill you every month at $19.99 a month. Guys, that's less than 67 cents a day, okay? And again, it's going to be billed monthly on your credit card, and you can cancel anytime. So try it for a few months. If you don't like it, you can cancel. And remember, this is an investment in yourself and your financial future. I have had numerous clients tell me that they've made tens of thousands of dollars or more in 1 year because of their subscription to Simple Market Signals and the information that they get. Guys, you think about the ROI, right? The return on investment like that, on that. That is amazing, right? When you think that you could spend a few hundred dollars a year and make thousands, tens of thousands, or perhaps even more, depending on the size of your account, based on that small investment. So, remember, there's always a cost of doing something, but there's always the cost of not doing that thing as well. And when you think about the decision of whether to become a member to this channel and have access to the Simple Market Signals information, there's a cost, right? $19.99 a month for doing this. But when you look at the cost of not doing this, guys, for most of you out there that are watching this, the cost, the lost opportunity cost, the profits that you're going to give back when the market pulls back, right? If you don't have this information and act on it, or the cost of not being in the market when there is a green signal and the market is advancing, the cost of not having this information for most of you is going to be much, much higher than the $19.99 a month, the 67 cents a day, right? The less than 67 cents a day that it's going to cost you to be a member of this channel and have access to this information. And to become a member of the channel and get access to the Simple Market Signals information, you will need to go to the Rodney E. Constable Stock Market channel. So depending on how you found the video, you may or may not be there, but you need to make sure that you go to the Rodney E. Constable Stock Market channel, and then you're going to click on this join button. Now, if you're not signed into YouTube, you will need to sign into YouTube, okay? So you'll need to sign in. All right, and then once you're signed in, then you'll see this box pop up, right? Get access to exclusive perks when you become a member. So you click on the join button, and you will see the information here, what you're going to get with your subscription, of course, your membership. and then you click on the join button, and you want to add your credit card information. So as you can see here, you can pay with either a credit or debit card, enter your card number, of course, the month and year of expiration, security code, cardholder name, and your billing zip code. So I'm going to fill all of this information in, and I will be right back. So once you hit that buy button, which is in the lower right-hand corner of that box, that previous box, you will then get this pop-up. Welcome. It's great to have you as a member. So then you can click on the See Perks. So once you fill all that out and your membership is established, then you will have access to the membership area where you will be able to see the perks, right? And then you go over to the community tab, and this is where you will have access to the various videos, and you just click on those and it'll pull those up. Okay, so I'm going to back up here, and so this is where all the training videos will be, as well as the weekly updates to the Simple Market signals that will be under the community tab. And that's all it takes to become a member. It's quite simple. So join now to immediately start benefiting from this proprietary information.